So there's a racetrack 45 minutes from here. Cool. You can come down anytime you want, drive whatever you want. You can even drive one of my cars.
Will I become a race car driver?
Yeah.
Next, no.
You should probably come not.
No, no. Nobody wants that. Nobody wants that.
A new way to start the day,
dude. Last time we were in Plano, it was like 80 degrees. It's like 2 weeks ago. It's like 40 now. Very cold, miserable looking. But big day today. New labels. This weather is actually fitting for the labels that we're running. Seasonal labels. It's gonna be a good day.
Off to get coffee
and bring some seasonal joy to all of you legends.
Okay.
Seasonal label day, big day. Frosted sugar cookie. With this one, I knew we were gonna, this was gonna be a little tricky because of these colors. Is there any way we can get a little bit more contrast in here? Because you can't really, you can see the doming, you can see it, but it's kind of really hard to make out the actual design in the background.
All right, I'll be right back.
First label of the day on the classic ghost seasonal label, ugly sweater vibe. This one's kind of like a tonal white gray. Based on the art on the screen, I kind of knew this one was gonna be a little tricky because colors are so close together back here that it's kind of hard to make out the actual art. To the camera, it probably just looks like a white label. However, we did do some doming on this, so it feels cool, but I think we just need to get a little bit more contrast there. So should be pretty easy to dial in, a couple passes, and we should be able to get this. It's gonna be sick. Dan would be proud. Bringing back the Santa snapback. It's that time of year. Seasonal labels and Santa snapbacks. Frosted sugar cookie? Look at that.
It's a quick one this morning.
You get that texture on the camera? So we never domed this pattern before, but doming of the pattern really kind of sets it off. It's obviously a very tonal, muted label. In person, really comes to life. Ugly Christmas sweater, ghost season away. Frosted sugar cookie this year. Second one's coming up. Definitely excited for that one. Huge day. Festive cheer. Big hat guy. Got three hats here today.
I've had three hats on me.
How many hats things do I have in this clip? Go with this one. Label number two, ghost. Hot cocoa mix. Excited for this one. This is actually one of my, from an art perspective, one of my favorite labels we've ever done. The chocolate and the marshmallow pieces that are domed, whole thing looks awesome. We're gonna couple this with basically the same art on like a hot chocolate box. And inside that box will be six sachets, which will be just like this. Your old school hot chocolate mix packets. We're pretty close on those. We're gonna lighten this graffiti just a hair to make it super, super subtle. These have a nice kind of like rubber feel to them. This product's a home run. Woo!
Marissa crushed it.
She crushed this one. This label is sick. Seasonal drops this year are gonna be insane. Festive as f. Just like that, Holden, we're back in Chicago. I think that might have been the quickest trip ever
to
Plano. Guys were ready for us this morning, knocked out both seasonal protein labels, plus the sachets that are going into this super cool box that we're knocking out too. So I don't know why I'm wearing this Santa snapback. Feeling good. It's cold out. It was cold in Dallas. Holidays are coming.
In Vegas.
Not in Vegas, Holden.
What's up, dude? Looks like Dan wants on.
Let him in. Yo.
or a picture of
Oh my God, what is that picture?
You put that there. Oh. Don't act like you didn't hold. First of all, the fact that you're in a sleeveless shirt in November is annoying me.
It's the best time of year in Vegas. Got a big week. The sign's coming in this week. If I can't see the sign from the deck at the Ghost condo, then either you didn't go big enough or I got to get my money back for the lace.
Holden and I were down in Plano, and I don't think I've ever been in Texas when it's that cold. It's literally 35 degrees.
Probably good weather to run those seasonal labels up.
Frosted sugar cookie.
Wow, that the sugar cookie on Zoom looks like some straight snow camo.
Domed the chocolate and marshmallow pieces. Wow. Seasonal as f***. Those are done. Successful trip down. Wore a lot of hats.
Hey guys, wait 1 second. I think Mr. Mailtime entered the waiting room.
Oh my gosh. How does he even know?
You invited him. I'm sending this guy the invite.
Holden, you did it.
Dude, guys, I just thought he could, you know, the seasonal spirit, you know?
Seasonal spirit of Mr. Mailtime. Oh my God, it says Mr. Mailtime.
It's mail time! How did you even know we were here?
I know everything.
I feel like Ricky's like now like Matrix Ricky, and he's just like
coming in through the code. Yeah.
I love that. I don't know, I've been like Holden clearly told you we were doing this because I have some packages here. I think Ryan got one too that we were going to open virtually together. And I guess it is fitting that Ricky is crashing the party. So
four locations.
Mail time coast to coast, Ricky. Who would have thought it would end up here from the first time you screamed those now historical words? Why don't you go first?
I've got a special package.
And anytime you see the DHL tape, you know it's real. Brookie sent us this from Australia. Look, Brooke and Matt and Chris are quarantined down in Australia and productive though, wanting to kind of do some cool ghost stuff. She developed ghost beach towels, since she knows how bad I want beach towels. Whoa. Oh, so this is like a gym size.
Yo, that is dope.
That's pretty sick.
And here's like the beach size.
How's the weight? Whoa.
man, these are sick. And the fabric is like, it's tough to describe. It's kind of like a microfiber thing, but apparently these are like those cool Aussie towels that keep getting targeted with ads on Instagram where if you get sand on it, it just kind of like comes off. And I've wanted to do beach towels as like a merch item for a long time. And maybe because it's the right season in Australia, we work with Brooke and get these going down under before we bring them to the States. But
full transparency with a lot of these merch items, a lot of people probably don't realize. It's like, you think, oh, let's do a beach towel. Well, if you want a premium beach towel, like literally the cost to us has, I've seen upwards of $40. So that's kind of where the challenge that we've had is that we want to do something super premium, super heavy weight, but we also want to deliver it at a price that's, you know, it's solid. So,
you know, if we want to do anything, but like a beach towel, for example, we want it to be as good as a company is that does nothing but beach towels. But we obviously don't have the buying power or the connections or the network to necessarily just go out there and get it for like the competitive price that you're talking about. I mean, I don't know. I have no idea how much these cost.
Need those in my life. Thank Shout out so- to Brooke. Get it done from Oz.
What else we got?
Ricky, you want to give us another one?
It's mail time! Box.
You got a big one. I got a traditional mail size box.
Oh, I know why I got a big one. It's because I asked the warehouse to reload me on marshmallow cereal milk. This is one of my favorite flavors, but I still have to say the OG cereal milk and ships wherever I need it.
Restocking tomorrow, by the way.
Stocking tomorrow. Look at that. Woo!
Ghost glow. Passion
fruit ghost glow.
That was bad. Hold on. Let me try again.
I only have one. Little glow, little Drake energy. Oh, since we're all here, why don't we dome it? We've never done a virtual dome before, right? Glow's been such a cool product, I think it's worth mentioning. Getting tagged in like befores and afters, I don't know if I was ever.
Some of them
I've
are crazy.
Been a fan of before and afters. I've never been a fan of it. But I feel like, of course, companies are gonna promote it. And that's why we, I don't think as a company, have really posted them a lot. But to just get personally tagged or see it in like the DMs, the ghost DMs, like how many people have had legitimately awesome results and improve their skin. And like, look, people obviously say like, you know, improving their skin, like they're like, man, I feel so much better. I feel confident. I feel great, rejuvenated. I don't know. It's so cool to hear. That definitely, I don't think was the goal when we set out to develop this thing. It was really, hey, what's a product that the fam asking about or asking for, and what can we do differently in that category? And I think, you know, the combo of Astrion and Verbastinol and dosing stuff like inositol and the correct amount and adding in the cetric glutathione, like it's it's a powerhouse. And I don't know, I'm very humbled that people have loved it and responded to it. And most importantly, that they're seeing the results from it that they have. It's so cool. So
this flavor beats blueberry acai for me.
Really?
I agree with that.
Wow, have you guys seen the comments where people are asking me if this is Dan's new favorite on the post? Look, it's really freaking good. A, it's really tough to decide between blueberry acai, peach, or this flavor, but I don't know. It's going to take a lot for me to not still be team blueberry acai. So that said, to the face, cheers.
Cheers, boys.
Cheers, boys. That's nice.
It is very nice.
Washed down with some red berry, also nice. Ricky, it's a good thing you're on this call, because I got one more thing for you. I've been told by Holden what this could potentially be. I like it, Ricky. Long time coming for these. Ghost Gamer Swedish Fish.
Woo! Let's go!
Peachy fish samples.
Rally
towel's going.
Well, let me tell you a story about Ghost Gamer Swedish Fish. It's my favorite flavor. Not changing, it's my favorite flavor.
You should give someone a chance to win a couple of those.
We'll do it right now. You want peachy fish? Comment below. We'll pick three winners. We'll dish out some samples.
They have to comment Dan's favorite.
But while we're on the subject of gamer, do you guys want to know what the number one question is on Discord and on our Twitch?
Yes, Ricky. I'd love to know.
When is Ricky going to get a snipe?
No. Well, when's okay, Ricky going to... Leave my gameplay out of this. Let's just want to know if there's any opportunities for them to play with the Ghost Fam. And obviously, yeah, the answer is yes. For more details on how to play with the Ghost Fam, join the official Ghost Discord. We'll be randomly selecting...
Is Ricky plugging the Ghost Discord on here? Is Ricky taking this time to plug the Ghost Discord?
We'll throw the link right on the screen right here. We'll be selecting three lucky legends to play with us this month, so be on the lookout for signups at the end of the week. Legends play coming to you soon.
Awesome. Good mail time. I'm gonna get out of here because I got a million things to do. Like I said, the sign's getting installed out here this week. I'm super excited to see this thing. So
send pics.
Lovely as always to see you. Ryan, you look great. Holden, cheers, my friend.
Great seeing you, boys. Thanks.
Peace.
Gorgeous day in Vegas. Big day for Ghost Vegas. Got this bad boy finally going up. Got hooked up with one of the best like LED neon sign makers on the strip, phoning some favors to make this thing kind of a reality. Actually, it's hilarious. In the sign meeting, the first one, the company's like, you know, what's your budget? What do you want? And Ryan just goes, I want to see it from the freaking strip. So
look at it. It's freaking bats.
28 feet wide, 12, 13 feet high. I think we accomplished that one. So it's gonna be cool to see this come together. Got some sampling due today. Got Bronson behind the camera from Ghost Hockey Club. We'll put an action shot right here. Cold in Chicago. So a lot going on today. Big things.
5 minutes later.
Ricky does like the whole, you know, Ryan does this like inverted thing. The average normal person. Now here's the thing. When the powder's in this little bag, you gotta be hypercritical. Once it's in the bottle, you love it, you brush your teeth. Especially on this product, guys, pull no punches.
I'm like, my mouth is watering already.
Okay, so we've got a V1 on this side, V2 on this side. All right, V1, cheers.
V2 has a little more sweet taste. Mm-hmm. Closer to authentic expectation, I would probably say V1.
How do you create something that's speaks directly to the collab and not just like a generic, the jet black cocoa? It's almost like a burnt flavor. Well, I mean, it's present in both, but just at different levels, right? Different notes, different levels of sweetness. I agree, V1. Would you make any changes to V1?
I would go just a little lighter on that one, but not as light as V2.
Mm-hmm. Well, the best part about these collabs, it's kind of a no pressure situation for me. I don't have to make the final call. I think it's definitely ready to present. Ryan and I sampled that in December of 2016 in that team. 4 years later, be at a place where it actually might happen, it's pretty cool, so stay tuned.
Oh man.
I brought you this. It's an actual RC car.
Whoa, you have your own RC car.
I do.
That is awesome.
So this car, this thing means a ton to me. This is on like hobby shelves worldwide, and I'm like, such a small like operation. And so when this hit shelves, it meant a lot to me. So I brought it to you just because it kind of represents kind of what you guys have done and building your brand. And
wow.
I mean, it's much smaller than what you've done, but it's
no
pretty,
way. That's
dude, pretty that rad.
So, man, yeah. that's like life goals right there, your own RC car.
It's pretty
like,
sick.
Say it up to the YouTube channel. So,
what's up, guys?
Michelle.
My name's Michelle Abadi. I'm local here in Vegas. Huge, huge Ghost fan. Probably hear it in my voice. I'm a little nervous to meet Dan and the guys.
No,
but
never. I'm nervous. You have your own RC car. I'm nervous.
Thank
yeah.
you. No,
thank
yeah.
you so much for coming by.
Yeah.
Pre the craziness and weirdness of 2020, like, you know, we love when people stop by the office in Chicago. So hopefully the world gets back to that, you know, soon. And I mean, Vegas is definitely going to be another hub for it. So you are the first legend to come and say what's up in Vegas. And
super honored.
I mean, my mind is blown. I'm like super humbled that even, yeah. It's funny, like, you know, a year and a half ago, our buddy Mark said, like, hey, Dan, you want to get involved with the hockey team? Mm-hmm. And now I play like 3 times a week. Will I become a race car driver?
Yeah.
Next, no.
Probably not.
Yes.
No. Nobody, yeah. nobody wants that. No. Nobody wants
so
that.
So there's a racetrack 45 minutes from here.
Cool.
You can come down anytime you want. Drive whatever you want. You can even drive one of my cars. If you're into it.
I might take you up on
if
that.
If you have enough courage to try it.
To strap in now.
I'll strap in.
Sign your waiver, homie.
Yes.
Thank you cool. so much. All appreciate right. it.
Yeah, for sure. This is our life. You keep coming back disassembled.
Having a quick shot, dude. Getting close. The signs are made. It's like a big kind of tarp thing over the LEDs. It's gonna be massive. You can see the warehouse from the deck of the Ghost condo. You can probably see the sign when it's all done, so that's gonna be pretty sick. But productive day. Sign from outline to just about there. Real magically plugging it in. Tasted some big stuff. Set it up to legend man Michelle. RC car. She's nervous to meet me. She's got her own RC car. Way cooler than me. Been a good day. See you back in Chicago. It's good to see you. I missed you last night. That's such a lovely color. Goes with your eyes. Before we fall asleep. Just wanted to say. This all seems so easy. The choices to make.